delighted are you to be receiving the Player of the Month award?
Yeah, it's a nice to get the award. It's obviously getting recognised for doing well for your team, but more importantly, the team started playing well and picking up wins, so that's the main thing. But yeah, I'm delighted to get it, obviously.
How good is the timing to get this award for yourself and the manager going into such a massive game on Friday night in the Dundee Derby?
Yeah, it gives me obviously an extra wee bit of confidence to know I'm doing well, but as I say, like, the team's been playing well and we've won 3 in the bounce, so that's ideal for going into the Derby, so that'll give us all confidence. But yeah, it gives me a wee boost.
What is it, do you think, that has seemed to have clicked for Dundee?
Well, we've been playing well, but just like maybe something just wasn't clicking in the final third, the last pass or finishing, but now that's all seeming to come together now as well. Kane's scoring, Gouzer's chipping, and I scored. So yeah, it's just seemed to sort of click, but we were playing well before, but now it's just really clicking and feels good now to get the results.
And you got 3 goals, I think it was, in October. You must have been delighted about that.
Yeah, it was starting to play in my head that I hadn't scored in a while, so I was putting a bit of pressure on myself and I was delighted. Got 2 against Arbroath, that kicked me on, and then scored against my old team here as well. So yeah, just hopefully more to come to help the team.
What kind of derby are you expecting on Friday night, given the heartache after the last one?
Yeah, I was looking forward to the last one and I knew it would be a big game, but it was even bigger than I expected, so I know what I'm expecting now. It's going to be a fierce game. Obviously, we're still chasing them, and obviously after the last one we want to get them back for that, so it's going to be a good one.
I was going to say, you've touched on there, how big a motivation is revenge going into this game?
Yeah, obviously it was 6-2, but we didn't feel it was a 6-2 game, we knew that, but obviously the scoreline doesn't look great, so yeah, we obviously want to get them back for that and want to win to try and keep up with them as well and keep try to chase them.
After the game at Tannadice, I guess there were a lot of people looking to see how Dundee would react, not just to a result like that, but to a result like that against your city rivals. Do you feel you, as a squad, have answered up to those questions and maybe silenced the doubters who some might have been suggesting you could have buckled after a result like that?
Yeah, there was some talk in that, and like I think there was a 9-point gap at one point in that, but we knew we were playing well. As I say, we were always playing well, it just wasn't clicking, maybe in the final third, it just wasn't happening. But we were confident it was going to come, and it's obviously started to come now, so we just need to keep it up and keep trying to string the results along.
And of course, if you win the game, you're just 3 points behind them.
Exactly, yeah, that's what I'm saying. There was all this chat about, a big massive gap, will you be able to make it up and that? And now, if we win on Friday, it's only 3 points. So yeah, we just need to keep doing what we've been doing and try to get wins.
Do you feel in some ways Dundee's recent good form has almost gone under the radar a little bit?
Yeah, you could say that. Probably because we were expected to do that from the start and we weren't doing it. But but as I say, it's really clicking now. We just want to keep this momentum going and take it into Friday's game.
How catchable do you feel Dundee United are at the top? Because they themselves, despite the fact also having 3 wins on a row, had 2 defeats prior to that. There is a bit of inconsistency there as well.
Yeah, this week, I've played in it last year and you've seen already there's been some upsets. The week we got beat off Thistle, they got beat and Ayr got beat, so MD can really beat MD in this league, so yeah, we know that they'll drop points as well, so yeah, definitely catchable.
Who do you think Friday night's game's bigger for, Dundee or Dundee United?
So probably equally big for both. Obviously they don't want to get caught and we want to catch them, and obviously they've won 3 in the bounce, we've won 3, so they're going to be up for it, we're up for it. It should be a good one, I'm looking forward to it, but hopefully we can get the 3 points and move it up to a 3-point gap.
Is it a game that, being the home side, that you put the pressure on to win the game?
Well, obviously we want to win the game. We know what it will mean if we win the game. We'll be just 3 points behind them. So we're going to be going out to win the game, yeah.
With it being a derby on Friday and all the hype that's associated with that, how difficult has it been to actually focus on it's just another match that you're going forward to on Friday?
Well, I try and do that myself because obviously you can get caught up in the emotions and like nerves and that, but I try to tell myself it's just another game. We know we've been playing well and we're just going to keep doing what we've been doing the last 3 games and try to play the way we've been playing and try and get another win, 4 in a row, make it.
On the flip side of that, does the fact that both sets of fans are from Dundee and the hype around the game, does that perhaps spur you on and give you more momentum?
Yeah, obviously you hear the town's buzzing, the city's buzzing or whatever, and you see everyone talking about it and it's going to be obviously sold out and all that. You do get a bit of excitement, but you need to obviously keep yourself level as well and know it is another game of football, but obviously it's a bigger one, but you still need to keep yourself composed and do what you do in every other game.